When the village of Troedrhiwgwair was built in the 1860s, it soon became apparent that the villagers living here had children. And not just a few children, there were lots of them. Anyone who now visits Troedrhiwgwair might see this wall and remains here, and wonder what it once belonged to. You might be amazed to know that it was once a school with 186 pupils. But even more thrilling than that was its Hollywood-style ending. From the late 1870s, houses 13 and 14 were used as the school, and basic lessons were provided for by the church. Although, it was mainly boys who attended.
In 1880, Parliament introduced the Education Act, which meant that it was compulsory for all children up to the age of 10 to attend school. It obviously couldn't be made compulsory immediately, since there wasn't a school building to attend. But by 1885, Trud School was ready to open its doors to the pupils. Originally, boys and girls had separate classes and separate recreational yards, although that did change in later years. The headmistress was said to be a Miss Mary Phillips, and members of the Mason family that ran the local pub were employed as teaching staff. The school successfully ran for infants and juniors, but by the 1970s, it was in quite a poor state of repair. There had never been any heating, and a lady used to go to the school every morning and light the fires before the children arrived. So it was in the summer of 1973 that the school closed for the holidays, but never actually reopened. All the children were sent to nearby Georgetown School, which had much better facilities. But no one knew that the school's biggest adventure was yet to come. The school stood empty for a decade until 1983, when location scouts from the BBC discovered Troedrhiwgwair and thought that it epitomised a typical Welsh mining village, so decided to use it to film the AJ Cronin adaptation of The Citadel. Later, the popular BBC drama The District Nurse was being filmed in locations around Tredegar. Soon, the small village of Troedrhiwgwair was invaded by cameras, crew, actors and props. The houses, many of which were already empty by this time, were all adapted to look like the 1930s. Plastic windows and doors were placed over the originals, and residents' living rooms went into darkness. Famous faces could be easily spotted walking down the streets, and you would be forgiven for thinking that the village had actually gone back in time. There were horses and carts and fake village shops. Hundreds of school children from the local primary were auditioned and used as extras. It was such an exciting time for this forgotten village. The empty school was once again full of children playing on the yard, and the sound of the school bell rang once more. However, it all had to draw to a close, and did so in such a climatic way. The school was due to be demolished, so it was agreed that the BBC could actually set it on fire for a thoroughly dramatic scene. It took place at night, and the flames could be seen for miles. But it was easy to believe that everything happening was real. What a way for this iconic building to end its days.
Now, the chapter on the school has closed. And those days are just distant memories. The teaching staff are no longer with us. But their knowledge lives on in the pupils that remain, and the legacy of Tredegar School will never be forgotten.